Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday Morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today, we're going to do a recipe out of this cookbook sent in by one of our viewers. And thank you very much for sending this in to us. I really love when old cookbooks show up in the post. There's so much to go through. This one in particular is called the Congressional Cookbook, National and International Favorite Recipes. And it is published by the Congressional Club in Washington, D.C. in 1933. And it is essentially a community cookbook. It is filled with recipes from senators and their wives and children, ex-senators, the wives of ex-presidents from the United States. And it is a real snapshot of 1933, what's happening at that time. And the recipe we're going to do today is called White Potato Pie, and it's in a section with sweet potato pies and pumpkin pies and other squash pies. And this is Depression, 1933. White potatoes, or just a regular potato, whatever you want to call it, just a regular potato, is very easy to grow. And I'm sure that it's something that people could grow anywhere in the United States. It's something that you can grow anywhere in Canada. Cheap, cheerful, easy to get. And so I'm only going to do half of this recipe because I don't need two potato pies. So there's the mashed potato, and in goes some sugar, melted butter, and two eggs. The next ingredient that it calls for is rich milk or cream. I'm going to use some cream, and I hope that I've got enough. I feel like I should have enough. Oh, just barely. And if I hadn't had enough, I would have just put in some milk, since they're pretty wide open as to what you can use. And this is the Depression, so, you know, you can make those substitutions, do what you can with what you have. So I'm going to put that in. Now the last ingredient, it calls for nutmeg or vanilla. Again, your choice, depending on what you have available to you. I have both nutmeg that I could grate in some nutmeg. And I know that every time I use nutmeg, people talk about the Townsends. In fact, this recipe was sent in by Miss Lila Townsend. So you can be sure that they used nutmeg. I love nutmeg, but I think this time I'm going to use some vanilla. I think that vanilla in this pie is going to be quite nice. And it doesn't tell me how much vanilla, so I'm going to guess about that much. Now the directions only say to mix. Really not a whole lot going on here. So I've got a really heavy whisk, and I'll just whisk this up as much as possible. Now, as I've been mixing this, one thing that I'll pass along is that you should really mash your potatoes well. Probably wouldn't go amiss to run them through a ricer if you have a ricer. I think you want them very smooth. Remember that carrot pie that I made? If you leave it really chunky, if you like it chunky, that's great. But I think for this one, maybe a little bit smoother. Now, the only instructions that this pie recipe gives are mix, bake with a bottom crust only. No temperature, no time, no size of the bottom crust. I chose to do a 9-inch shallow pie plate with our all butter crust, because I think the all butter crust will work for this one. So we'll pour it in, and hopefully I've got the right size crust. Oh yeah, perfect, perfect. Now the oven is preheated. So I was shooting for 375, but my new oven runs really hot. So I'm gonna have to put this in and keep a close eye on it. And I've put in my pizza stone because I found lately for custard pies where you're not par baking or pre-baking the pie crust, that pizza stone really gives a really nice bake on the bottom of the pie crust, something that I really like. So I'm gonna keep my eye on that and see what happens. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen. Hey, friends.
That is white potato pie.
White potato pie.
White potato pie.
Okay. Well, we'll need a fork.
Yep.
So is that like sweet potato pie?
It's kind of like sweet potato pie, except it's just made with regular pie.
So it doesn't have the sweet potatoes, right? Because, all right, yeah. I'm just digging in. It's kind of looks like a custard almost, but clearly not.
Well.
So
that's a little bit weird.
It is definitely like mashed potatoes in its texture, but it's also very sweet.
Super sweet.
I think it would actually be better cold.
Okay, so yes, because it is still a little bit warm from the oven. It took just under an hour to cook this.
It's kind of got a custardy flavor to it.
Yeah, so
the flavor's kind of custardy.
There are two eggs and there's cream, so it is kind of a custard. The only flavor is from the vanilla. It is a little bit weird, but you know what? I'm kind of really digging that.
Yeah, it's a lovely kind of just sugary treat. I think you could improve it in a handful of ways. I think I would add some additional flavoring,
mm-hmm.
like something that kind of broadens it beyond just the vanilla.
Now, this is a dessert.
Mm-hmm.
What if you took out the sugar
mm-hmm.
and made it savory?
Okay, but then it's just mashed potatoes. It's mashed potatoes in a crust.
It is just mashed potatoes. It is just mashed potatoes in a crust. Okay, so in the way that a lot of recipes from the 1930s during the Depression are simplistic and not terribly flavorful because you're using what you have,
mm-hmm.
you could add on this.
Well, you know, you could go with the classic, add dates.
You could add dates. I mean, you could add raisins. You could add you could add dried fruits.
You could add some cardamom.
Cardamom would be really good.
Right, so all those things that we say for almost every recipe.
Because it's available to us now. But I will still sit down and eat that. I was a little bit worried. Because it is just mashed potatoes in a pie crust. Maybe because of, you know, my heritage, mashed potatoes in a pie crust is a good thing.
Okay, but, I mean, let's put a context to this. It's basically a custard. And a custard you can put in bread. You can put in rice. Yeah. Apparently you can put in mashed potatoes.
The mashed potatoes is the filler. Slap that down and I'd be happy.
All right, well, there you go, Glen.
So I'd say that this is something to give a shot.
But make it your own.
Yeah, definitely make it your own. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.